Good morning, my dear students. So let us begin the last part of chapter 3, decimals. So today we will see how to do division of decimal by a decimal. Earlier we have studied how to divide a decimal by 10, 100 or 1000, and we have also seen how to divide a decimal by whole number. Today it is decimal by decimal. So please see one example. The example given is 30.94 by 0.7. If you see, both are the decimals, numerator and the denominator. So 30.94 divided by 0.7. Now here what we will do, our work is to make the denominator as a whole number. How to make denominator as a whole number? 0.7, when you will multiply with 10, you will get a 7, and 7 is a whole number. So now when you are multiplying 0.7 with a 10, to make it equivalent fraction, you will multiply 30.94 also with 10. So the new number will be 309.4 divided by 7. And now this we have already done. How to divide and get the answer? You will follow the steps, you will get the answer as 44.2. Now for the same question, one more method is there. 30.94 divided by 7. If you remember, in the last class we have seen how to write the decimal into the fraction part. So 30.94 can be written as 3094 by 100. Don't ask me how I have written this by 100. How I have written? Because 0.94 means two digits after decimal. So writing the same number and beneath the number adding two zeros. Divided by 0.7 is written as 7 by 10. Following the rules of division of fraction, 3094 by 100 into 10 by 7. And when you will multiply it, again you will get the same answer, that is 44.2. You can do any of the method, whichever you are comfortable in. Next example, 26.313 by 1.75. Again here, both the numbers are decimals. So what is our target? Our target is to make the denominator to a whole number. Whole number is the presentation in which it doesn't have a decimal. So if you see, 1.75 has two digits after decimal. So what I will do, I will multiply it with 100. When you will multiply 1.75 with 100, you have to multiply 26.313 also with 100. So that the value of the fraction remains same. So the new digit formed is 2631.30 divided by 175. And then doing the division, 2631.30 divided by 175. How to proceed? 175 ones are 175. Subtracting it, we will get 88. Now I will copy the next digit, that is 1. So then 175 fives are 875. On subtracting, I will get a 6. Now, if you see a decimal is here, I will place the decimal in the quotient area and I will copy the next digit, that is 3. So 6 and 3 became 63. Now 63 will go how many times? 63 will go only 0 times. So 175 zeros are 0. 63 minus 0 will be 63. Now I will copy the last digit, that is 0. So 63 became 630 and 175 threes are 525. On subtracting, we got 105. I'm only getting here 105. Since we have a decimal in the quotient area, we can add a 0 here. So 1050, and then how many times it will go? It will go 175, 6 are 1050. What is left is 00. So the answer is 15.036. And in order to check, you can multiply your quotient and your divisor. So today's classwork is, I am taking example 3.3 of page 41. Question number 2 is 25.5. It's a divide. Divide 25.5 by 0.5. So as I told you, the target is to make the divisor or the numerator to a whole number. 0.5 into 10 will give me a 5. When I will multiply 10 down, I will multiply 10 up. So the new number will be 25. 25.5 into 10 will be 255 and 0.5 into 10 will be 5. So it is 255 by 5. When you will divide, you will get the answer as 51. Fifth subpart, 2.73 by 1.3. So 1.3 into 10 will give you 13. Fine. So 1.3 into 10. So into 10 down means into 10 up. 2.73 into 10 is 27.3. Then follow the same method and get the answer. Question number 3 is 36 by 0.4. Again, divisor or the denominator is 0.4. So I will multiply it with 10 so that it becomes 4. So 10 down means 10 up. See, wherever I am doing the multiplication with the same number, I am doing up and down. So that the value remains same. The value of the fraction should not change. They are equivalent still. So 0.5 into 10 is 4 and 36 into 10 is 360. Now 360 by 4 will give you a 90 on division. Fourth part, 7.75 by 25. So here I am not doing, because 25 is a denominator and denominator is itself a whole number. So I am not changing it. I started my division 7.75 divided by 25. Now it's a 7. So how many times it will go? 25 zeros are 0. 7 minus 0 is a 7. Now we had a decimal. I will put the decimal to the quotient area. I will copy the next digit, that is 7. So the new number is 77. 25 threes are 75. Then 7 minus 5 is a 2. Copying the next digit, that is 25. And 25 ones are 25. In order to check, you can do 0.31 into 25. You will get the answer as 7.75. Question number 4 is find 12 divide by 8. 12 divide by 8 can be written in fraction as 12 by 8. Remember? And we have studied how to change fractions to decimals. So same thing I am doing here. 12 divided by 8 will give you 1.5. We have done this kind of questions earlier also. Now let us consider one word problem of this exercise. The total weight of a certain bag of rice is 650.16 kg. If each bag weighs 10.32 kg, find the number of bags. Solution will be, total weight of a rice bag is given as 650.16 kg. Weight of one rice bag is given as 10.32 kg. So therefore, number of bags will be total weight of rice bag divided by the weight of one rice bag. So it will be 650.16 divided by 10.32. Now 10.32 I am multiplying with 100 so that it becomes a whole number. So multiplying 100 down should be followed by multiplying 100 up. So the new number will be 65016 divided by 1032. When you will do the division, you will get the answer as 63 bags. So now your today's homework is question number 2, third part and fourth part. Question number 3, sixth part. Question number 4, second and fourth part. And question number 7. So total of 6 questions are given as homework. Please submit them only in the evening. I request you, I am giving you selected questions. Do them and submit for proper checking. Other questions you can do in your rough copy to upgrade your skills. I hope you will follow what your teacher is saying. Kindly submit your works on time. Thank you. Have a nice day.